Hello, YouTube, right? This is Charles again. Well, I'm working on the bucket truck now. The other day, like Saturday, I got it all washed off with a pressure washer. Now, I got the letters removed, and I'll be doing some rust repair on this. Yep, this is the rust. Right there. Oh, yeah, look at that. Oh, boy. I'm going to fix that. Well, first, you want to replace the door, but I don't know. I think I'm just gonna fix it. Show y'all how to fix this. First, I'm gonna, I guess, grind it down a little bit, and see, I got a hole there. That side first, I just the inside piece from here to there is all rusty. Course there, and get the camera in there. See what we got going on in there. So that's what I'm gonna take to fix that is I'm gonna spray rust kill on both sides. I'm gonna soak it. That's right, I'm gonna soak it with rust kill on both sides. I'm gonna spray rust kill on both sides to kill all the rust, and that's how I'm gonna fix that and spray the rust kill on both sides of that, because I got surface rust, but the rust didn't go all the way through, just surface rust on that. So that's how I'm gonna do that. And this fender, I want the fender fixed, so I'm gonna fix that. Do y'all a video on how to fix a private glass fender on a vehicle. I still got those letters to remove and that. And that's it. He helped me remove some of the letters, but he got tired, so. And it's like 9 o'clock at the night. Y'all gonna spray rust kill on that. Spray rust kill on this. Rust kill on that. I got some spray, some rust kill on the inside. So I maybe need a gallon of rust kill, I think, what I'm thinking. Spray rust kill on that. What else am I gonna spray rust kill on? I think that's it, because he wants all these handles replaced. Because he said he wants to lock them. I guess so he don't have to take his equipment out every day, because if they lock, then you don't have to worry about people stealing his stuff. So I'm gonna fix this. He said just paint, fix the outside, but I think I talked him to fixing all that, because why are you gonna fix this outside? How the outside look good if this is not fixed? Because so I don't do that, I'm gonna kill the rust on both sides, I'm gonna soak it, and when the rust gets black, then I'm gonna spray etching primer on it, on the inside and out, so say it won't come back again. I'm gonna then coat it with fiberglass. I think long strand fiberglass would fill all that in. I don't know, I might back it, do some backing on it on the inside with fiberglass resin, and resin all that in, then put fiberglass on the outside to fill the rest in. Maybe something like that on that. Let me close the door. So that's all I got to say about that. So talk to y'all later. Bye. Hello, YouTube guys. This is Charles again. Well, I'm working on the bucket truck. I started sanding. I got that off, better edge down. Looks pretty good. Just got it down in 80 grit. I got this side filled with edge. Still working this side, spray some up more rust kill. The rust kill I'm using is called Rustmont. It's I got a gallon of that. It's Rustmont SMC 69504. Yeah, this is gonna be a long job. Well, I guess I'll see y'all later. Bye. Hello, YouTube Garage. This is Charles again. Well, working on that bucket truck again. Well, I just got doing some fiberglass on it. I got this filled with short strand fiberglass over here. That's filled. That's ready to put Bondo on. This is ready for Bondo. And over here, I got the crack fixed for fiberglass, the inside and out. And this is ready. Put fiberglass on the top. Now, that's ready for Bondo. And this under here, see right there. That's ready for Bondo. Because I just filled it in real quick so it won't look so bad. I killed all the rust. I still got a little bits of holes, like, if you can zoom in. Wait there. Little pin holes there and there. I'm just gonna fill that with Bondo, so since it's not that big. I filled the big holes with short strand fiberglass, then I went over with, long strand fiberglass, then I went with short strand fiberglass to go over the long strand. Looks pretty good now. So the rest I can just fix with Bondo. Cause this inside door, I'm just gonna fill in it so it won't look too bad when I paint it. So, all I've done so far today, I did some more sanding on today on this side of the door over here. I got all this sand, I sprayed rust kill, and it go back with that with 80 grit. So I'm about this far on this side of sand at the bottom of the truck. Then I got to move to the top of the truck and sand all that down. But he wants the top part, I think, white, he said. He wants the bottom part yellow, so. That's all I've done so far, so let me get back at it. I might do a video on Bondo, how to lay it and sand it. So I'll talk to y'all later. Bye. Hello, YouTube Garage. This is Charles again. Well, I'm still working on that bucket truck. Well, I'm taping it up now. Man, this is a big tape job. I think I about got one side taped up. Worked on it 3 hours, taped one side up. Goodness. So, I got the other side to tape. I got the tape up there done. Down here. Because I got to tape it all up before I can start spraying primer. Still thinking about, should I prime the whole thing or just spot prime it? It looks like it's going to be a total prime job on the sides. So I'm gonna prime the whole side on this side and prime the whole side on the other side and prime the back, and I'm gonna prime the whole hood too, because that's what you see. That can look really good for him, because the paint he got actually is still on order. Turn that light off. It's still on order. He got I think he got Viper yellow, like this. Bottom part gonna be yellow, top part gonna be white. Oh, that's gonna be white. So, I'm gonna be spraying for days on this. I guess my first project is gonna be, after I get it all taped up, I'm gonna spray up there first, since that's white. I'm gonna spray that white. Then I'm gonna cover all that up so overspray won't build. Now start spraying the yellow. So, First, I'm gonna prime it, so I don't got to mess nothing off when I prime it. Well, I don't have enough paper for this project. So, that's all I gotta say now. Talk to y'all later. Bye.